Simon says, don't smile. Okay, I can't actually see, so I'm counting on you guys to be the judges. All right? How are they doing? No one's smiling? No one's smiling? That's good. All right, here's what we're going to do. Oh, is that a smile? What is she doing? She's just bobbing. All right, all right. Is she out? Yes, all right, you're out. Yellow sweater, you're out. All right. Guy in the blue, step over. You're out. Thanks for playing. All right.
I'm hoping that they go home with a bit of an excitement. Obviously, we hope that they've learned something from the day, from one of the workshops or the presenters. But all in all, I hope that they just carry away the message that that the Lord loves them and that they are originals, made originals, as is our theme for the day. We need our young people to step up and be voices, to get involved in ministries, to take on different things in their parishes, to lead Bible studies and youth groups and what have you. It's important because our parishes wouldn't be the same if our young people didn't fully participate or if they didn't have a place to fully participate. I'm hoping that the graces of today's rally kind of light a fire in a lot of people and make them realize that the young people are wanting to learn more about their faith and they're wanting to exercise their faith.
I'll tell you the hardest thing that ever happened in my life. I lived in a town called Littleton, Colorado for 13 years. I worked at the church there called St. Francis Cabrini. You can look all this up. The public school, walking distance from our church, is a school called Columbine High School. At Columbine High School on April 20th of 1999, two students walked in and they killed 11 students and a teacher and themselves. 14 people in total died that day. It's the worst thing that I ever experienced. It's not the only time it's ever happened. I hope it's never happened to you. Because it's like having someone punch you so hard that you can't breathe. I was driving my mom to the airport because she was visiting and my phone started going off and going off. And you know, my pastor at the church was calling, and he never calls my cell phone. He's like, get here now. So I get there, and literally, we have about 250 kids, teenagers, that go to our church, come to our youth group, go through confirmation. They go to school at that school. They literally jumped out of windows, ran out of fire exits, and ran to the church. They ran to the church. You know, and we gathered, and we just waited.
Steve's story is timeless, really. It's unfortunate that Columbine High School, the tragedy at Columbine High School, seems to have been so long ago, but we're living with those events currently, and it's certainly not something foreign to our young people, so I certainly think it resonates. And on the inverse of that, I think it also provides a glimpse of hope for our young people. They're here hearing a story, 20 years ago, and Steve talked about how the community at Columbine is on the other side of it and that their faith was a big part of what got them to the other side of grief and towards hope. And I think that's a very relevant and timely example. It's unfortunate that we still have to talk about things such as that, but I think it's a timeless message because our young people still worry about those things today.
Today you can get a lot of influences to, you know, put you in the wrong direction that God would want you to go. So sticking close to the Bible as like your reference, or it doesn't have to be like you're asking your priest for advice or a nun or whatever you want, it leads you in the right direction other than, you know, other sources like social media and whatever else. It can more of like, it can tilt you from like your way to sainthood.
God is asking you today is, do you know me? I think I lived most of my life putting Jesus Christ and Luke Skywalker in the same category. I'm serious, you know. Two guys with really cool movies, you know. You ever watch the Chosen Son movies? Really good, right? They do all these amazing things. They walk on water. They float things with the Force. It's very powerful, right? It occurred to me one day that the difference between Jesus and Luke is that Jesus is real. He didn't need George Lucas to create any special effects, you know. He's God. And I think we live in a very cynical world. We always have, but especially so today. You live in a world that cuts down and tears down everything good. And you know what? Church is no exception. God is no exception.
I'm really excited to take part in the rally today to really grow closer to God and really learn more about our faith and understand it on a deeper level, not just like knowing about it, but truly understanding it and getting to know it, not just like knowing the definition of whatever word in the Bible, but knowing truly what that means in your life. I think it's really important. At my church, actually, I am one of the lectors. I'm the youngest lector there. And it's really cool after Mass, each time I do it, people come up to me and they congratulate me and they say, hey, that's great. When I was your age, I would never do that. And I just think it's really important to get to know everybody in the community, and not just that, but to get to know and learn from the adults, and just really so that I could live out the rest of my life and do that well.
I think it's important to stay close to your faith because, like, there's a lot of things going on in the outside world, and having at least one thing to rely on is really important.
What has been your favorite part of today so far?
I think adoration. Just the peace that it brought me. I've never done it before, so it was very nice.
Every time I've done adoration in this kind of environment, it's brought me just sort of peace. And I think the Holy Spirit just comes to you and says, you can do this, because the journey's hard for adults who are leading kids. So I hope that the experience leads them closer to the Lord. But mostly, I think I hope that they embark on the journey of confirmation with a renewed identity in Catholicism.
We cry, holy, holy, holy and true. Amen, we do believe our God is here.
We are really pleased to have the presence of so many young people from around our diocese here today to give thanks to God, to celebrate, to worship, and to pray.
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father.
In my life, I began to realize that I was not living for God. There was nothing dramatic, really, but I realized that I was not bearing the fruit in my life for God. I was bearing the fruit for others. If this is the case for you, maybe you've realized that when you decided that you didn't want to be a teacher, just like your parent was a teacher. Or you didn't want to be in a relationship, just because people have told you that you should be in one. Or you didn't want to be involved in a sport or activity because your peers thought that you should. Those things are living for someone else, being a photocopy, bearing fruit in someone else's vineyard, not living for God and being the original that God created you to be. Friends, God desires that we bear an abundant harvest. All of us, each and every single one of us, fearfully and wonderfully made, uniquely in the image and likeness of the God who created us. So be encouraged tonight and throughout your life, that as beloved children of that God who created you uniquely and fearfully, wonderfully made in his image and likeness, to be an original, and ultimately to produce an abundant fruit for God that no one else can bear except for you.